How do we recognize God's will in our lives? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God. Every day, amen.
From tax collector to apostle and evangelist, this is the arc of St. Matthew's life. He was called Levi, which means God's gift. The Jews despised Matthew or Levi, a publican, because he was considered in cahoots with their oppressors, collecting the taxes that Jews paid to the Romans. It's possible people also thought badly about Matthew because of his roots. He was a Galilean, son of the tribe of Levi. They were seen as being sympathetic to the occupying Romans. When Jesus saw Matthew, he told him, "Follow me," and he got up and followed our Lord. Matthew organized a banquet for Jesus, who came with his disciples. The scribes and Pharisees were not happy with the presence of publicans and sinners. Jesus' answer greatly touched Matthew. "They that are well have no need of a physician, but they that are sick." Jesus added, "For I came not to call the just, but sinners." Though we don't know so much about the life of Saint Matthew, we know that he was close to Jesus. He became an apostle and authored one of the four gospel accounts. St. Matthew's gospel was written with an audience of Christians of Jewish origin in mind. The text emphasizes that Jesus is the Messiah who fulfills the promises of the Old Testament. He is also mentioned a few times in the Acts of the Apostles. The proclamation of Christ would be his life's mission. All the other early records of Matthew's death claim he was martyred, but they disagree about how and where it happened. The early church fathers said he was either burned, stoned, stabbed, or beheaded. Other traditions have it that his earthly life ended in Ethiopia. His relics are located in the crypt of the Cathedral of Salerno. The story of Matthew and the painting of Caravaggio mark the life of Pope Francis, who shared about it in his interview with Father Antonio Spadaro, S.J., in La Civiltà Cattolica in 2013. The Holy Father described himself as a sinner to whom the Lord turned his eyes. As Jesus passed on from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me," and he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners.'" Saint Ignatius of Loyola said that the first way to discern God's will is a time when we experience a clarity beyond doubting, which is a result of a special grace from God. In today's gospel, Jesus only spoke two words to Matthew, "Follow me." As a result, Matthew abandons his former life and becomes Jesus' follower. What was it that convinced Matthew to follow Jesus? Clearly, there was much more than just Jesus' two-word invitation that convinced him to respond. It was a special grace from God. Somehow Matthew knew in his heart that God was calling him to abandon his former life and to embrace this new life. There was no long discussion, no weighing of the pros and cons, no prolonged thinking about it. Levi just knew, and he responded. It is important to be aware of the fact that sometimes God does act this way. This is a great gift when it happens. And though this depth of instant clarity is not always the way God speaks to us, it's important to acknowledge that God does speak to us this way at times. Let us reflect today upon this call of Matthew and the inner certainty that he was given at that moment. Let us try to imagine what he experienced and what others may have thought of his decision to follow Jesus. Let us be open to the same grace and be ready and willing to respond without hesitation. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, thank you for calling us all to follow you without hesitation. Thank you for the joy of being your disciple. Give us the grace to always recognize your will for our lives and help us to respond to you with total abandonment and trust. Jesus, King of Mercy, we trust in you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and Couples for Christ.